Hi, welcome back to SourceFed. I'm Lee Newton.
I'm Elliot Morgan.
Oh. Love! It makes you do crazy things. You know, like let someone take up an entire door while you die, even though there's room for both of you. Or how about save an entire town from the tyranny of non-dance? Or how about stay up way too late watching House of Cards? There's no pictures, just me, actually. I stayed up way too late watching House of Cards.
You're talking about a love of show, right?
Totally. But apparently love, or more specifically the love hormone oxytocin, generally associated with trust and bonding, can make people lie.
Unbelievable. Researchers from the National Academy of Sciences found that subjects given the hormone lied far more readily when it served the interest of their team while playing a game.
Compared to those given a placebo, those that took oxytocin told more extreme lies and told them more often and without hesitation.
I 100% understand that. Just play any game with me ever, all bets are off.
They really are.
Unless I'm in a casino. That's the bets are on. And I'm probably getting kicked out and having my knees broken.
They found that in order to protect and promote the well-being of others, humans may bend the truth and behave unethically. Again, the reason being that oxytocin promotes affiliation and cooperation with others. And the even crazier thing is, when lying only served personal self-interests, oxytocin had no effects. But it wasn't just lying that the subjects experienced, it was extreme lying. I don't even know what extreme lying is.
It's like when you're playing group Monopoly and you and your wife have like kind of different rules on Monopoly.
Yeah.
And she was raised to think that like, oh, free parking is just like, you know, the standard rule where you don't actually collect any money. Like that's the regulation rule.
Yeah.
But like it adds, and it's also more like economically relevant to like represent 2014 these days to allow there to be something where you could be way down and land on that one space and then get an influx of cash. It makes the game a little bit more competitive as well as give people a fighting chance rather than obliterate them over a 4-hour period. But she doesn't seem to understand that. And it's not a big deal. So therefore, sometimes I steal people's money and houses.
Oh my God.
You know, because we win in my house.
Oh.
We win in my house.
Oh.
We win in my house. Do you understand? We win in my house.
No, totally.
Totally. My house, we win.
Yeah.
We win in my house.
Yeah. So guys, what's the biggest lie you've ever told while playing a game? Let us know in the comment section down below.
And also while you're down there, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. We have an annotation that you can do what you want with. My name is Elliot Morgan.
And I'm Lee Newton. Or better yet, what's the biggest lie you've told while being in love? I once convinced a guy I was British for like 2 weeks.
Really?
Yeah.
That's horrible.
Yeah. I didn't know what to do.
Was he British too?
No.
You're just effed up.
No, it was more like I said a British accent as a joke, and then like he was actually a really nice guy, and then like on a phone call I'd pretend to be British, and then I was like, well, this is weird. Turns out he wasn't that cool of a guy though in the end, so it was like easy to separate.
Oh, good. You were just like, everything we're doing is a lie.
Yeah, I mean, it's mildly sociopathic, but whatever.
Yeah, a little bit.